Random House Audio presents The Werewolf's Guide to Life, a manual for the newly bitten, by Ritch Duncan and Bob Powers. Read for you by Robertson Dean. To all those living with lycanthropy, this one's for you. Remember, take it one moon at a time. Read this first. 1. Werewolves are real. 2. If you have been bitten by a werewolf and survived the attack, you will transform into a werewolf. Your transformations will occur on the evening of the full moon, as well as the evenings immediately before and after the full moon, waxing and waning. These are popularly called your moons. The first transformation will happen roughly a month from the date of your attack. To be clear, if the full moon falls on the 15th, you will transform into something very, very dangerous on the evenings of the 14th, the 15th, and the 16th. 3. If there is a full moon approaching and you have even the smallest suspicion that you have been bitten by a werewolf, listen to Chapter 5, Tips on Your First Transformation, immediately. 4. If you do not know when the next full moon will be, find out right now. 5. The majority of lycanthropes who do not have access to the information in this book die during or shortly after their first transformations. Causes of death are generally heart failure, gunshot wounds, exposure, drowning, or suicide. 6. The bulk of the information in this book was originally circulated in the form of Xeroxed, handwritten copies of the collected writings, observations, and oral histories of people who have both lived and died with lycanthropy. That information has been supplemented via interviews with lycanthropes and those whose lives have been touched by lycanthropy. 7. This book was created to save human lives, including yours. 8. Hollywood horror movies are not to be used as guides to living with lycanthropy. Their goal is not to educate, but to entertain. As a result, they are largely ignorant of the realities of the condition. 9. Ignorance creates monsters. Lycanthropy does not. 10. You are not a monster. Notes on the text. Names and identifying details. Where lycanthropes and their loved ones are identified by their full names or other identifying details, those names and details have been changed to protect the individuals from those who might do them harm. Testimonials. The introductory paragraphs of each chapter are first-hand accounts of people who are living with lycanthropy, who have a loved one who is a werewolf, or whose lives have been touched profoundly by the condition in some other manner. They are excerpts from much longer interviews conducted by the authors while researching this book. The authors thank these brave individuals for sharing their experiences so that future lycanthropes might learn from them. We also thank them for trusting that their anonymity would not be compromised, and we have gone to great lengths to make sure their identities remain hidden. True legends. These text inserts are taken from stories that have been passed down from werewolf to werewolf over the years. We cannot be sure of their veracity, but even if they turn out to be false, we believe they are still helpful, either as allegories or coping mechanisms. These legends have persisted for a reason. Use of the male pronoun. In many cases throughout the book, we rely on the use of the male pronoun he when speaking of a hypothetical lycanthrope. This is done solely to aid the readability of the text and should not be seen as confirmation of the myth that lycanthropes are always male. Any human being can become a werewolf, regardless of gender or race. Use of the terms werewolves, lycanthropes, and non-likes. Throughout the text, we use the terms lycanthrope and werewolf interchangeably. It is a commonly accepted colloquialism among lycanthropes to refer to themselves as werewolves, and our text reflects this. We have tried to refer to non-lycanthropes as simply non-likes rather than humans, since lycanthropes are no less human than non-likes. Further, in many traditional texts on lycanthropy, the werewolf's two states are divided into the human state and the wolf state. We believe that both of these states are experienced by the same human being, and so have tried to avoid referring to one state as more human than the other. To this end, we have made a point of signifying the lycanthrope's pre-transformation state as his dormant state, and his post-transformation wolf-like state as his wild state. So, you've been bitten. Introduction. Welcome to the Werewolf's Guide to Life, the definitive manual for the recently bitten lycanthrope. If a werewolf has recently attacked you, or you've already transformed into a werewolf, we urge a thorough reading of this text. Thousands of werewolves living in the 21st century have jobs, families, and obligations. They are artists, business people, and scholars, Democrats, Republicans, and independents. They have backyard barbecues and home gardens, and they celebrate holidays from Easter to Rosh Hashanah to Ramadan. Unlike the rest of society, werewolves happen to have a condition that, three times a month, causes their bodies to almost double in size, triple in strength and agility, grow a thick mass of tightly woven fur, and transform from an unremarkable human being into a savage, wild animal, resembling, but distinctly different from, a wolf, whose behavior patterns are generally dictated by voracious hunger and rage. There is no known cure for this condition because, strictly speaking, it is not a disease. With care and discipline, it is manageable. This book is written primarily for the recently bitten, stage 1, lycanthrope. This is a person who is scared, confused, and unable to process what is happening to him. The ignorance of stage 1 lycanthropes makes them a danger to themselves, general society, and the community of well-adjusted, non-violent werewolves who have found themselves persecuted as a result of the rampages of the terrified, uneducated few. If we reach just one of these newly bitten werewolves and are able to save his life, and by proxy, the lives of his neighbors and loved ones, we will have achieved our goal. This is not a guide to learn how to fight off a werewolf, and this is not a guide to learn how to become a werewolf. It is a guide to help newly bitten werewolves learn how to retain their humanity. So, if you are one of these recently bitten people, congratulations on your decision to read this far. It very well may have saved your life. What we are presenting to you is a workable roadmap that will allow you to come to grips with the realities of your condition, design an ethical life for yourself that can be lived to the fullest, and avoid premature death, killing the innocent, or passing your condition to another through violent attack. This book includes everything from short-term survival and transformation techniques to long-term guidance, including diet, wellness, both physical and mental, living arrangements and environments, vocations, dating, sex, love, and child rearing. If you have any interest in staying alive, keep reading. The Authors, September 2009. Part 1. Say Hello to a Brand New You. Chapter 1. The Basics. It was a nice night for a walk in the park. Bright, big moon. Out by the picnic area, I heard this deep, low growling. Scared the hell out of me. Then I heard it circling, rustling in the bushes, moving around behind me. I began to think I was in real trouble. When I heard the howl, I knew it. As it exploded out of the bushes at me, I thought two things. It was a rabid animal, and I was done for. Wrong on both counts. We smashed straight through the picnic table, shattering it. I was found the next morning, barely alive, with a dead, naked man impaled on a shard of the broken table next to me. I've come around to believing that I was lucky. I didn't always feel that way. Marty H., political consultant, age 34, like age 10. Getting started. If you've been bitten by a werewolf, or know someone who has been bitten, you probably have a head full of some pretty weird and wild questions. This section will go over the basics of what lycanthropy is all about. What is lycanthropy? Lycanthropy is a biological condition wherein you undergo a cyclical physical transformation, experiencing sudden and drastic growth in all parts of your body until you appear to have been turned into a creature that is half human, half wolf. Those who have this condition are called lycanthropes, or werewolves. When you undergo this change, you experience rapid hair growth. Your teeth turn into large fangs, and your fingernails grow into long, sharp claws, and your body increases in height, girth, and strength, with longer limbs, a more pronounced brow, and in some cases, an extended snout. During the transformation, your mental state experiences a rapid deterioration, eroding all of your higher faculties until your mind is that of a bloodthirsty predator. You will become hungry for flesh and will maul and feed on animals or humans, given the chance. In your wild state, you are extremely dangerous and hard to control. You remain in your wild state for approximately 8 hours before you transform back to your normal or dormant state. When it happens, you will experience a transformation 3 nights out of the month, on the evening of the full moon and the evenings before and after, when the full moon waxes and wanes. These nights are commonly referred to as your moons, and the monthly trio of moons is referred to as your moonset. On the morning following each transformation, you will wake up in your dormant state again, usually with little to no memory of the events of the previous night. How one becomes a werewolf. You can become a werewolf either by being born to a lycanthrope father or by having a werewolf's blood or fluids introduced into your bloodstream, usually through a bite. The fluids must enter your bloodstream while the werewolf is in his wild state. If you are bitten by a werewolf in his dormant state, or if the fluids of a werewolf are introduced into your bloodstream outside of a transformation day, you will not become a werewolf. How it happens. The blood and saliva of werewolves contain a contagion that acts upon the pituitary gland. After you've been attacked, this contagion travels through your bloodstream and causes your pituitary gland to release a rare and normally dormant thyroid-stimulating hormone called lycanthropin. Lycanthropin acts upon the thyroid and other glands and organs to stimulate growth at a rapid rate, first by causing a breakdown of body structures and then by swift cellular regeneration and reproduction. This hormonal process makes the body grow to nearly twice its normal size and stimulates the hunger and rage receptors in the brain to such an extreme degree that you begin to behave like a starved, wild animal. The process continues for 8 to 12 hours until the body counteracts the change and triggers another cellular breakdown, changing your physiognomy back to your dormant state. For purebloods, lycanthropes who are born to a lycanthrope father, the pituitary gland is pre-programmed to automatically release the lycanthropin hormone during moonsets after the pureblood reaches puberty. Is there a procedure to prevent the pituitary gland from releasing the lycanthropin hormone? People who have been recently bitten or lycanthrope parents of pureblood children might seek a surgical procedure to inhibit the release of lycanthropin. There is no such procedure that we know of, but were there such a procedure, we would oppose its practice. Disabling or manipulating the pituitary gland to inhibit thyroid function is an act of mutilation that would impair the body's natural development and drastically alter its overall chemistry. Were such a procedure performed on a child, it would prevent that child from going through puberty and subject him to a life far worse than that of a pureblood lycanthrope. You might wish that your child were like all of the other non-likes, but impairing physical development will achieve the very opposite effect. You would be intentionally handicapping your child and stunting his growth. Who can become a lycanthrope? Any human being, male or female, regardless of race or background, can become a lycanthrope. However, the condition will not become active until you reach the age at which puberty begins. Non-humans, animals, cannot contract lycanthropy. Why is lycanthropy tied to the phases of the moon? The lycanthropin hormone is released in measured doses throughout the month, hitting its peak after approximately 29 days. During the first month, you will notice.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.